project was called Perspectives because it was a way of showing the perspective of music and the perspective of dance, but also the children were doing a project to do with perspectives in their philosophy class as well.
We decided to look at perspective because it links really well across the whole curriculum, in history, looking at different characters' perspectives from the past, and also in the playground, we're often discussing social issues and things that have arisen at playtime. We then linked it to our literacy topic, and the children have written some absolutely amazing poems.
Could you please go to your starting position?
I'm the dance specialist at Brooklands. I work here one day a week. It's taking from their philosophical discussions about ordinary everyday things and looking at them in a different way, so changing the perspective. So we began making a short phrase in groups of three or four, using a pedestrian movement, something everyday, something ordinary.
Remember, we said if you're not dancing, you're absolutely still. But it's the quality of your stillness, isn't it? You do have to make it worth looking at. All right, shall we try it again? They're doing their hair. Hair and makeup is going on. Come on.
It gave a lot of opportunity to look at composition in the music because we decided to not use any real instruments, but to sample their environment, get the children to play their school, so to speak, as opposed to learn a musical instrument and compose that way.
The first thing we did was go around school and record very sort of strange sounds and put them onto a mini disc. Then we loaded them onto a software on the computer and we loaded them onto a keyboard. Here's an example.
We collected samples from absolutely anything and everything that we could possibly imagine.
That was the bouncy ball.
Would the kids get it? They're excited about the technology, they're excited about putting it on a keyboard and playing it back. And once it's on a keyboard, we can detune it, spread it across a keyboard so it can play a melody.
That was the cello.
Yeah, that was the cello. Or was it the piano? I think that was some people screaming. That was an airplane coming over.
Yeah. You know, it kind of got them to use these things, which they don't really use.
I know, I like the challenge of making a soundscape of absolutely anything.
You could sample these chairs being scraped, the tables being opened, a sort of little symphony in itself.
Also, I was borrowing six PlayStation portables from our local City Learning Centre to explore using handheld technology to evaluate dance work.
So we used the PSPs, which had cameras on top, to record things.
Some groups were performing and other groups of three were filming, and they were allowed also to film from different perspectives. We filmed from into stairwells, children dancing below. For me, it was as if year five were seeing dance for the first time through their little PSP.
We looked at that and we thought, what could we change in that, or anything we could do to improve our dance?
Probably one of the first schools to use this technology, which is actually thought to be for children playing games on, but you can actually use it for learning as well.
You see all the dances in a different way, like Alexander's dance is about clocks, but some people wouldn't really see if it's about clocks, and they might think it's about something different.
The way they've had to focus on looking at different points of view have really made my class consider each other and become a lot more empathetic.
That's great, well done. Lovely. Better stillness, well done.
It's been really fun because of dances and things like that, and filming each other. That's what I really found interesting and fun.
Thank you. thought the sophistication of the movement was amazing. They learnt that, you know, the detail was amazing, and they remembered it all, and they worked very well together, and there was contact work and floor work, and she put on a really good performance.
They're seeing dance in a different way. They're seeing it through that screen, you know, so there's no distractions. They can see what's happening, you know, they can use it to film themselves, they use it to film other people, and it's like instant feedback.
It was very clear from their performances that by watching themselves on the PSPs that they could evaluate their own work, and they really understood what they needed to improve on.
They don't learn steps, they learn how to create a dance, and that's absolutely vital, and it all sort of culminates in this. So that performance experience is obviously important as well.